This show is clean.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
Episode 718. Hello, it's Mike Matthews broadcasting from the last place on Earth located somewhere in Podcaster Valley, California. Today, Madam Rutabaga Valentina Bison Bentley plus the return of the much-loved segment Into an Interview, where I speak with Annam Burnett of the San Francisco band Danger Maker, and Jenny McCarthy has revealed what her next plans are. Oh, I bet you can't wait.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
To find out what they are, but I have to tell you that I did something of late.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
I went to a wedding that featured the girl you hear on this show. Say it's time for the podcast picture, and we'll see you tomorrow, don't you know, at the end of the show. And what the last show I forgot to mention, Benita mentioned she had an Italian boyfriend who sucked on her toes.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
The disgruntled fiddle player wasn't too happy to hear about that. Hey, what about Germany?
Mike's
winning that
Daily
soccer match
podcast
World Cup thing.
Yeah!
That's interesting. But enough about that, because that was days ago. Yes, this show today has a little bit to do with weddings. Look, just walked in.
Hello, Michael. This is Madame Rutabaga. One second. That talk sexy ends of the show. Got married.
Yes, Ariel got married this past Saturday. Went to that wedding. It was wonderful. But here's something I noticed, and that is people do not know how to start a conversation, and they always rely on the, well, at weddings, they know, you know, how do you, they say, how do you know the bride? How do you know the groom? But I'm getting really sick of hearing, so what do you do? As if we're defined by what we do. But I guess in some ways we are defined by what, because I'm telling you, if I didn't do this, you wouldn't know me. And people ask the question. But my thing is, though, people, when they ask that question, they usually don't really even care what the answer is. So their eyes get glazed over anyway. But the best example of how this question can go wrong is in the movie Notting Hill, when Julia Roberts, who's playing a star of similar stature to herself, is sitting with a bunch of people that are, you know, friends of her civilian, not popular boyfriend, played by Hugh Grant. And the guy, they're at a dinner, and the guy says to her, who doesn't know who she is as a superstar, asks her, you know, what do you do? And she's like, oh, I'm an actress. Oh, you bet you don't make much money doing that. And she's like, no, actually, I do. And it's kind of a joke. And that guy that asked her that later played Lord Grantham on Downton Abbey and still plays that. And I'm a nerd for watching Downton Abbey.
But Michael Matthews, that show is so beautiful. There's all the people dressed in the period costumes.
Yeah, just like this show. Oh, look who else just walked in.
Hello there, Mike. This is Valentino, the parking attendant.
And this is Bison Bentley. Do you know that?
Mike, we wish we could have gone to our weddings. We love to eat lots of food and drink booze day.
Yeah, it's one of our funnest activities that we like to do. Do you know that?
You guys, I thought coming here and doing the show with me was one of the funnest activities.
Ha ha ha, that's a laugh. The only fun thing about doing this is that we get to dress up in period costumes day.
And find out things like that Benita the Rodeo Queen used to have her toes sucked on by an Italian boyfriend. Do you know that?
Yeah, I do know that because I told you that at the beginning of the show in the song.
Michael Matthew, maybe you don't like to be asked what you do for a living because you don't even know what you do.
I know what I do. I do a podcast. I do this thing and interview people like the cool band Danger Maker, which is coming up in just... Let's hear it for Danger Maker! Yeah. They're coming up in a moment, and it's so I'm just... This is what I do, sort of. It doesn't define me. I'm an enigma.
Mike, I think there's an ointment for that day.
Yeah, rub it a little bit on, it'll go away. Do you know that?
Thanks, guys, for that suggestion. Well, Jenny McCarthy, who used to be on The View, is now going to be on Sirius XM. She announced today the former View panelist, will now host a live, limited-run, hour-long weekly series on SiriusXM starting Wednesday, July 16th, entitled Dirty, Sexy, Funny with Jenny McCarthy, according to popwatch.ew.com. Jenny plans to discuss everything from parenting and marriage to dating and sex. Chelsea Handler, Perez Hilton, and McCarthy's fiancé, Donnie Wahlberg, are all scheduled to appear. Donnie of New Kids on the Block. Yeah, two people that make you want to punch the 90s in the face. And, of course, Donnie's Mark's brother and Jenny McCarthy joined The View last year, though her contract was not renewed for the fall. She left the show earlier this month along with Sherry Shepherd shortly after the retirement of Barbara Walters. Rosie O'Donnell, formerly of The View, is going to join Whoopi Goldberg, who is the only remaining member from last season, this fall. McCarthy made her name as a comedian, actress, Playboy playmate. She's written books on parenting, hosted her late-night talk show called The Jenny McCarthy Show. She has been linked to anti-vaccine activism, a position that has been criticized by many. And on her last appearance on The View, Jenny promised that her next project would allow her to talk without having to interrupt anyone. The View, what a lovely show. What do you think of Jenny McCarthy's new plans? Do you care? Do you find Jenny McCarthy is the rock in your life? Comment by emailing me, mikesdailypodcast@gmail.com. We read your comments on the section emails from email. Also email me there if you'd like to be a guest on the show or if you'd like to sponsor the show, mikesdailypodcast@gmail.com. And we also have the website, mikesdailypodcast.com, where we have links to where to listen to the show in iTunes. Subscribe to the show in iTunes, and you can rate and comment on the show there. If you do that, more people find out about us. There's also the Facebook page. Like the Facebook page. And when I post a new show, share it with your friends. More people will find out about us that way, too. The Facebook page link there at mikesdailypodcast.com, as well as links to where to find us on Twitter, Tumblr, Yelp, Mixcloud, Spreaker, SoundCloud, and YouTube. There's also the Amazon deal of the day. Click on that and buy something at a great discount. That helps us out too. And there's the blog, the daily podcast picture, and all the past interviews that I've done, all there at mikesdailypodcast.com. And speaking of interviews,
into an interview.
Hello?
Adam, it's Mike.
Hey.
It's Mike's Daily Podcast. Adam, sorry, my number looked like someone you didn't want to talk to.
I'm sorry, I did too.
But I know how that, when I see unknown on my cell phone, I'm like, it's going to voicemail.
No, it's weird. Yours came up as specifically someone who used to play in Danger Maker who we had a falling out with.
Oh, no.
I don't know how that happens. It's weird.
Wow, well, I would love to play in the band Danger Maker because it's an awesome band, but I don't know what I would play. You've already got a keyboardist, and he's awesome.
Yes.
David DeAngelis, right? Is his name?
Right.
And your drummer's Corey Aboud?
No, Carlos.
Carlos
Rodriguez.
Carlos Rodriguez.
Yeah, Corey's a friend of ours that filled in for a show recently.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's what I got it from that picture that was on your Facebook.
Yeah, yeah.
But Nico Fuzzmonk is your bass player, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Neko.
Neko.
Yeah.
And you've got a great band. I've seen you play at the Bottom of the Hill in San Francisco.
You did.
And it was a great show.
Oh, cool. When did you come?
That was back in like March.
Okay.
I think.
Cool.
And so how did you guys all get together?
How did we get together? Over time, I guess is the best answer. We were all kind of playing around in the city doing different musical things, and I was doing more of solo acoustic type stuff, and I think I just got tired of that, and the music I was writing wasn't very well suited to that either. So I started looking for people to play with, and I first found Carlos, our drummer, and we worked up some of our very early songs that turned into our first EP, and just slowly wanted to fill out the sound with other people. So Dave, our keyboard player, had moved from the Mississippi Delta. I'm sorry, the Arkansas Delta.
Oh.
So, yeah, he brought a lot of different influence to the band. Great musician. And he was playing in a different project with Necco. So it was kind of a two-for-one.
Oh.
Two-for-one deal.
What was their project? Yeah. Did it have a name?
It did. It doesn't exist anymore.
It's no longer.
As far as I know. It was more of a jazz kind of R&B.
Interesting.
Thing. Totally different.
Yeah, it is fun to watch Necco play and David play. And they just, yeah. You guys really...
Yeah, Necco's a performer.
Very animated and fun. And, you've got a gig coming up at the Stork Lounge Club in Oakland.
Club, yes. That's in a couple weeks in August. And then this Friday, we've got a show in San Francisco at the Elbow Room.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, to kind of celebrate the new release that we're doing.
Tell me about that.
Yeah, so we've got some new songs. We're about to release an EP of three songs that we're all pretty excited about. And so this Friday we're gonna release the first single off of that.
And that is?
It's called The Light.
The Light.
Yeah.
And I was going to play that.
Cool.
And what was the inspiration for this song?
That song, it kind of started out quite a bit darker sounding. And I think if you kind of listen to that versus our other older stuff, we had a kind of a darker sound before. And we've kind of been trying to mold it into something else. So this was an example of a demo that I came in with that was pretty dark and kind of something inspired by a couple years ago, my father passed away, and a lot of that's come out in the music just here and there. So anyway, I brought in this idea to the band and we all kind of played around with it and ended up taking it somewhere completely different. Which has been happening a lot with us lately, and it's good. It's been kind of going to a new direction that we're all pretty excited about. So, yeah, this is a good example of a song like that.
So Adam comes in with an idea, with a demo, and then the guys do something else with it, kind of evolve it, add to it, like a snowball.
Like a snowball, like ping pong. But I've always felt like you kind of need that initial idea or structure of some sort, or else you're just kind of noodling around, you know?
Right.